off each other tonight. I'm going to be asking him some questions. He's going to, shall we start off with, you want to explain a little bit about your experience with the kids? Anything else that I haven't said?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was really great fun to go to the schools, and I was probably more nervous for that. Going to the schools was, it was great fun, but you never know how they're going to react. And but seventh graders were the first one, and that was the absolute best because they really put in, and they had so many stories. In fact, we had to kind of pull them in a little bit. Okay, so does that, you know, tie in here, and does that tie in here? But it was a lot of fun.
Tell us, set the stage for us, what is fantasy?
Fantasy, when we were talking with the kids, they pretty much always got it right, because we just say, what is fantasy? Does anybody know what that is? And they just say, make believe. Yep, that's it. That's exactly what it is. That's pretty much all you need to know about it. And then we got into the specifics of the genre that I had chosen, which was more specifically middle grade, medieval, high fantasy, which is a lot of ugly words that just means I like monsters and sword fighting. It was really good because they know that, and of course they've read, a lot of them had read Harry Potter, and a lot of them had read Lightning Thief or The Hobbit, just stuff like that. And so they knew what I was talking about. They're like, okay, this is what this kind of thing is.
And why did you choose fantasy?
That's easy. Fantasy is easier than anything else, I think. Because if you just make it up, then you don't have to worry too much about if you're getting it right or wrong. it makes it easier because, and of course there's the obvious why any of us read fantasy. I think it's the same reason why I would ever write it, is because it's not real. And nobody wants to listen to or deal with real problems. And, well, we do sometimes, but we all need a little fantasy, so it was really easy to choose that genre because I knew I wanted to write something, and that one, it just came out as that because it was easy and the problems were more fun to solve, and I could put whatever I wanted.
Let's set the stage for them and tell them about your main character.
My main character, his name is Den. He's a young boy. He's young high school, middle school aged, and he lives in a tower. He's an orphan with his best friend. So they're practically brothers, and they're living in this tower. And he came to me very easily because he became me, and that's something that I found that as I write any character, that it just becomes you. There's little I could do about it. I'm what I know, and it's really difficult for me to write anything that isn't at least part of me. So he came really easily. I just knew what he was going to say always, and I knew what he was going to do. And the character flaw there was very significant. The whole theme of this book largely is dealing with courage and getting over your fears, and he, as a young boy, you know, has to learn to come and face those fears and little by little make choices that he can trust himself. And of course that came easy because I have the same character flaw. And I told the kids, when I was a little kid, I had a lot of phobias, I guess you could say. I had a lot of worst fears. I was afraid of the wind. I was afraid of dogs. I was afraid of short people. I was afraid of clouds. I was afraid of sunsets. I was really always just looking over my shoulder and just a shaky little kid. And so that was really easy to come up with because, well, he was, you know, he had the same character flaw. And so going on a quest with him through a really dark, scary forest with monsters and stuff, that it was actually quite therapeutic to go on it with him because I could see him going through that. I'm like, okay, you know, I can, if I'm going with Den, I can do this because I'm writing it as him. So.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to introduce the book? We were choosing some pages that you might want to read get them into it.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah. So I'll just read the first little bit. Okay, yeah, it's about 2 pages. It's written like a journal. It's first person, so it's written as if Den is recording this from later. And chapter 1, Wanwood is what it's called. It was the year 1000 from the origin of magic, month 5 and day 30. I began lacing up my shoes in the middle of the night. I don't remember what time it was exactly, only that I was tired. My mentor, Master Brindle, had told me to go out with Belt and collect some twigs for wand making. Sometimes I wonder if he had us go during the night on purpose, just strengthen our character or whatnot. I pulled my old brown leathery shoes on tight and stood up in them. They were my mentor's before they were mine, and by the time I received them, they were pretty well worn out already, with a few scrapes and scratches here and there. But they were still decently sturdy and actually quite comfortable. My friend Belt came stepping down the staircase that spiraled around the tower we called home. I say friend, but really Belt was more like my little brother, since we'd grown up together. Master Brindle had raised us in Abram Tower like we were his own children. It had been our home for as long as Belt or I could remember. "You're coming with me, aren't you, Den?" Belt asked me with worry in his voice. He and I were both nervous about going into the forest at night. "Of course," I said encouragingly. "Oh, good. I hate going into Shavewood." Belt then picked up a smallish pouch hanging on the end of a stair rail, and I picked up a similar one from the wooden table in front of me. "Do you have your Atham?" I asked. Belt specialized in wand making, and his Atham was an enchanted knife made just for that. He searched all his pockets without success and finally found it in his shoe. He pulled out the small knife. "Yes, all right, let's go," he said resignedly, and we both left the camp.